In a historic judgment which would determine the credibility of the 2019 elections based on irregularities such as faulty EVMs and the absence of a voter verifiable paper audit trail, the Chief Justice Peter Chivute dismissed the appeal lodged by independent presidential candidate Panduleni Itula, Popular Democratic Movement Party President McHenry Vanani and three other presidential candidates to set aside the 2019 election results and have a rerun.
The determination by the minister that the provisions of Section 97 of the Act were brought into force with the exception of subsections 3 and 4 of that section on the 17th October 2014 by Government Notice number 208/2014 is in conflict with the Constitution and is invalid. B. The aforesaid determination is set aside. C. The aforesaid setting aside and order of invalidity will take effect on 21st March 2020 unless the determination by the Minister under Section 209 is withdrawn by the Minister before such date, in which event it will take effect upon the date of such withdrawal. D. The validity of the election of office bearers elected under Act 5 rather of 2014 before 20th March 2020 and action taken by them is not affected by this order of invalidity. And finally, E, the first to fourth respondents are jointly and severally ordered to pay two-thirds of the applicant's costs, including the costs of one instructing legal practitioner and two instructed legal practitioners. The one paying, the others to be absolved. That was the judgment of the court.
Today on One spoke to the independent presidential candidate, Panduleni Itula, who took the opportunity to congratulate President Hage Geingob for his victory in the 2019 presidential elections. Itula also called on his followers to respect the legitimacy of the incoming president and to uphold the rule of law.
I should take this opportunity, under the circumstances, to congratulate Comrade Hage Geingob for the victory, albeit without a paper trail. He is now our legitimate president of this republic, and we should respect him. And I caution everybody who has been following the phenomenon for change to act within the principles of the rule of law and to respect our head of state. It's up to the Namibian people to determine exactly what is it that they want their leaders to do. Today, this court has given the Namibian people another leaf to ensure that they hold the leaders accountable. I started off teaching them the Constitution. That is the weapon. Our weakest is the ignorance of our rules. And that weapon of that very fundamental principle of justice is the only weapon the Namibian people has now. And that is what I will emphasize you use. Read your Constitution and ensure your local authority, your regional authority, your minister and your president acts within the realms of this Constitution and the laws that emanates from it. I shall not go away.
So it's not the end of you?
It's not the end of me. It's not the end of the thought process.
According to the Chief Justice, the applicants delayed in their effort to challenge the conduct of the elections and should have applied a month in advance. The ECN chairperson, Advocate Notemba Chipwea, said that the ECN accepts the judgment, adding that the applicants challenged the ECN on irregularities and not the transparency of the electoral body.
We are fine with the outcome. We have presented a sound arguments to the court. The applicants also presented their arguments. And the court has applied their minds to both arguments and have come out with a judgment. They've exercised their discretion and we uphold the rule of law and we accept the judgment that has been given. There was no argument that was properly put forward by the applicants on irregularities, and I think the court made that very clear. So the aspect of credibility of the election was not in question, was not an issue. I think it was more the issue of the implementation of the operationalization of Section 97.
The SWAPO presidential candidate, Hage Geingob, will be inaugurated as president of Namibia on March 21st, where he will serve his second term in office.